Streaming services have been duking it out for the rights to our favorite movies and shows in a royal rumble for our ever-dwindling attention spans.
You have all of our attention just by screaming anything.
That's good to know.
On this IMDb Brief, we compare what upcoming paid services Quibi, Peacock, HBO Max, Disney Plus, and Apple TV Plus have to offer in exchange for your precious time and subscription dollars. Let's begin with Quibi, because their model is all about speed. Scheduled to launch in April 2020, Quibi is aimed at busy millennials who watch 10-minute episodes on their phones. With over a billion invested, Quibi has already hooked A-list talent and creatives like Game of Thrones' Sophie Turner, Steven Spielberg, Catherine Hardwick, and Don Cheadle. For $5 per month or $8 to stream without ads, you can watch Quibi's original series like a Judge Judy-esque reality show with Chrissy Teigen, or a reboot of The Fugitive with Kiefer Sutherland. NBC's Peacock only just got a name, but it'll be ready to go head-to-head with Quibi in April 2020. They've been paying big bucks to hold the rights to their beloved back catalog, shelling out an estimated $500 million just to regain the rights for The Office, but losing Seinfeld to Netflix for an even higher sum. Alongside Cheers and Frasier reruns, Peacock will have movies from Universal and Focus, plus reboots that'll smack you right in the nostalgia bone like Battlestar Galactica, Punky Brewster, and Saved by the Bell. NBC will use their broadcast rights to the 2020 Olympics to roll out more information about Peacock, including the price tag.
It's not a bad idea.
Can't remember if you have HBO Go or HBO Now? Well, in 2020, HBO Max arrives to confuse you further. Actually, the service is being called a big sister to HBO Now because it's a standalone service separate from a cable package. Considering you get everything HBO Now offers at $15 per month, plus 10,000 hours of Warner Media back catalog like Friends, Fresh Prince, CNN, Adult Swim, and The CW, just to name a few, as well as originals like Tokyo Vice with Ansel Elgort and an animated series based on Gremlins, an HBO Max subscription could land in the $20 per month range.
I mean, don't you think this is incredible?
Disney Plus has been open for beta testing in the Netherlands, minus their upcoming originals like The Mandalorian or live-action Lady and the Tramp, which won't drop until the service's worldwide release on November 12th, 2019. At $7.99 each month and with the entire Disney vault at your fingertips, Disney Plus has done their best to undercut the other services. But don't be surprised if that price creeps up as Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel release a slew of new series and original movies on the service throughout 2020 and 2021.
Bounty hunting is a complicated profession.
Apple TV Plus plans to beat everyone to the punch with a $5 per month service that debuts on November 1st, 2019. With an Emily Dickinson comedy starring Hailee Steinfeld, a morning show dramedy with Reese Witherspoon, Steve Carell, and Jennifer Aniston, and a post-apocalyptic thriller headlined by Jason Momoa called C, Apple TV Plus hopes to hook you with a small catalog of big-name originals instead of a deep catalog of beloved hits.
We are doing this my way.
If all these pay services have you overwhelmed and you'd rather watch new and old classics like Drive, Rain Man, and Columbo, as well as IMDb originals like No Small Parts and The IMDb Brief, all for free, IMDb TV has you covered. Check it out on Fire TV or at imdb.com/TV.